الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله، لا إله إلا الله علي ولي.
Speaking of how the prophet follows the tradition of other prophets, the verse in the Quran once again. وَوَاعَدْنَا مُوسَى ثَلَاثِينَ لَيْلَةً. We summoned Musa for 30 nights, Allah says. وَأَتْمَمْنَاهَا بِعَشْرٍ. Then Allah added 10 nights to the original 30 as part of a test that He was implementing. So 30 days were then complemented by another 10 days. فَتَمَّ مِيقَاتُ رَبِّهِ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً. The total now is 40 nights. وَقَالَ مُوسَى. So, now Musa's being summoned for 40 nights, right? Suddenly, Musa speaks to his brother Harun. أُخْلُفْنِي فِي قَوْمِي. O Harun, I want you to succeed me in my nation. وَأَصْلِحْ وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. And be a muslih, be a source of reconciliation. If they turn against you, if they fight you, if they coerce you, if they threaten to burn your house, if they threaten to kill your wife, whatever they do, be a source of conciliation. In other words, don't fight back. Be patient. Subhanallah, how history repeats itself. وَلَا تَتَّبِعْ سَبِيلَ الْمُفْسِدِينَ. The Quran then tells us that Musa went away for 40 nights. He came back. By the time he returned, within less than 2 months, imagine, they were already prostrating before the golden calf. Non-stop prostration. They abandoned all the miracles, all the things they had witnessed. Everything was now gone. And they were back to idol worship. Musa goes to who? Goes to the one that he appointed. The one that was given the responsibility. He goes straight to his brother. He grabs him by the hair and starts to pull him. Harun says to Musa, this is all in the Quran. He says to him, يَبْنَ أُمَّ إِنَّ الْقَوْمَ اسْتَضْعَفُونِي. My brother, son of my own mother. These people outnumbered me. These people found me to be weak. So don't let them rejoice at you punishing me because this is not my fault. In other words, 40 days go by and suddenly all of the companions of Musa, all of them, every last single one of them, turns against his appointed successor. Sound familiar? How could all the companions turn their backs on their heels? Is that even possible? All these great companions, their sacrifices, this, that, and the other. Sound familiar? My point here is this. Musa's going away for 30 days or 40 days, and he won't leave his people without a successor. The Holy Prophet is about to leave this world for good, and he leaves them without a head, without a successor, without a leader. Nothing. Just leaves them in the cold, dark world of ignorance that they were in. Despite all of their antagonisms, all their vitriol towards each other, all the hate that they harbored, all the fights that they had between them, which later manifested itself in the most graphic manner in Hurub al-Ridda and so on. The Holy Prophet just leaves them hanging dry just like that. How does that add up? How does that make any sense? This entire universe that was, subhanallah, the way it runs is so incredibly, infinitesimally efficient and perfect. Suddenly this one area that has to do with not running a small company. This isn't about running a town or city. This isn't about running a country. This is about running an entire religion, God's final revelation. Suddenly the Prophet leaves it up to the people to choose whoever they want.